Hey, what up, y'all? It's Pepe here, and today we're gonna be cooking for Valentine's Day, okay? Y'all like my new haircut? We're gonna be filming today for Valentine's Day. We're gonna be using this big old girl right here, okay? You know, make the perfect Valentine's Day treats. We're gonna be using candy and some other stuff that I think I know about. So yeah, let's get to it. Come on, guys, let's go get some ingredients. Delicious candy. Delicious. This will be perfect for the Valentine's Day meal. Hey, it's Valentine's Day. Y'all like games about love? Well, you'll love this, because we're going to be using Final Fantasy X. You know, that's a game about a couple, you know, loving each other. Okay. Y'all already know it's Valentine's Day. Gotta get them rose petals. Yes. Shrek. Oh, Shrek, why did you eat these? Oh, onions have layers, bro. Lollipop, lollipop, oh little lollipop, 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 oh little lollipop. Oh, we got Kirby, the gayest game alive. Yeah, let's use this. You already know. I'm literally the pepper called pepperonis. I'm not called that for nothing, so. For all of you disgusting virgins out there, you're some virgin olive oil. Extra edition. You know, I can't even talk, bro. Ooh, a mailbox. I'm using this. A gun. Not today. Some perfume. And lastly, a rose. Okay, everyone, now that we have everything, let's get ready to cook our delicious meal. Okay, everyone. Okay, guys, we're about to, you know, start our, the cooking part of the video, and I'm super excited, you know. We're only gonna put it in there for, like, 30 seconds. 30 seconds should be enough time for this to be in here. Okay, now it's time to press, start.
I see you have entered. Now, we're going to be reviewing 50 Shades of Grey. Yeah, so this is a terrible movie that I never wanted to watch, but I figured since it'd be a fun Valentine's Day topic, you know, there's a lot of love in it. Like, there's this rich guy who finds this girl. I think that's pretty romantic, but the movie ruins that in every single way. So I'm gonna have to review it, and I'm gonna bleach my eyes out afterwards. Warner Brothers, what were you thinking?
Okay, so here's how this movie goes. So basically, there's this girl, her name's Anastasia.
She's working at this dude's company. His name is Christian Gay. I mean Gray. But yeah, she's working at this company for him. And then she finds out that he's into BDSM. Which I don't know what the frick that stands for. But yeah, it's super kinky. And then they get it on. So then, afterwards, what they do is that they go up into Christian's place. And then they start whipping each other. Anastasia's eyes are closed. They just get at it up in that apartment. So then the movie shows that Anastasia is starting not to like the way Christian does stuff. Like, she's getting nervous because she's a boomer. And Christian really doesn't care. He just wants her for that nice bod, if you know what I mean. Yeah, so the movie just goes on and it's terrible and I hate it. And believe it or not, the day I'm recording this, the movie was released 7 years ago. Now, you see, what you may not, some people may not know, is that this movie is based off of a novel by British author E.L. James. Now, what you must understand about this book is that, one, I have not read it. I've only seen a few pages of it. And number two, the book was not critically praised upon release because, you know, they said the writing was terrible. There were some grammatical errors. They didn't check over it. And in general, it was just a bad book to some people. But, you know, you gotta give that BDSM a try. Now, you see, the thing about the 50 Shades of Grey movie is that it went on to make a whole buttload of sequels, which got worse as they went on. There's 50 Shades Darker. There's 50 Shades Freed. There's 50 Shades of Black, which is a spinoff made by the Wayans brothers. You know, the same guys who did Scary Movie. You know, those movies, the first one was good, but then they got worse as it went along, just like this movie.
What is?
My playroom.
Like your Xbox and stuff?
Now, you see, most of the problems and complaints of this movie is that this movie depicts people with BDSM fetishes as terrible, sadistic hedonists who keep poor, vulnerable women in their houses and expose them to terrible torture. And they make Christian seem psychotic just because of what he likes. But you see, Christian takes pride as himself in a man. But, you see, running a company and having BDSM, I think that's pretty hard enough. And Anna seems to be into it. She's just a bit confused, you know. You see, there's a scene in 50 Shades of Grey where they lick ice cream off each other. And, yeah, that ruined ice cream for me. I couldn't eat vanilla ice cream the same way again. You know, that's disgusting. Why are you licking ice cream off your girlfriend? And there's this extended scene of that ice cream thing on YouTube. Do not go watch that. I'm warning you right now, that's the most disgusting thing you will ever see. Just enjoy ice cream without watching that movie. Just you're better off without it, man. But yeah, apparently there's this thing from behind the scenes where it was revealed that the actors for the movie were forced into being friends. And you know, that's not a really good thing. You know, you want to be friends when making a movie because off the set, what really are you guys? You gotta be friends. You may be famous actors that can blow your wallet on some hoe and then come back to the house the next day. But, you know, that's really sad, man. But then, you also have to take into account the freaking box office sales of this movie. Bro, $550 million for a BDSM movie is not good. And for you sick fucks that went to go see that movie, I'm very confused. What is your mental state, sir? You know, yeah, I'm starting to sound like those dumb critics that were talking about the movie like this. But seriously, $500 million, bro. You know what you could buy with that? You could buy that expensive mansion with that evil supervillain Batcave lair thing. You could buy a part of a basketball team with that money, bro. And you're telling me this movie accumulated that money. Okay, I see how you Hollywood. But despite how bad this movie is, there's one thing you can do this Valentine's Day that can cheer you up. You can play a game called Catherine Full Body, a perfect game for Valentine's Day. You know, the challenging puzzles and the connected storylines, you know. And they added new stuff, like this girl, you find out she's actually a dude in the game, and you get mad. And Catherine with a K and C are still there. They still want to kill you, but yeah, it's a really good game. I recommend it highly. Or you could play Super Seducer. Or more importantly, you could play some Crazy Taxi. Beep, beep, beep. Crazy Taxi. Oh, yeah, you want to play some Crazy Taxi, boy? Get my taxi. But pay me. You ain't going to be late. We're going to go deliver you to our destination. This ain't no Uber, this is Crazy Taxi. Great, 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 Crazy Taxi. Yes, sucker.